Welcome to Springfield, Massachusetts, home of the Basketball Hall of Fame. And today, it's also the home of the NJCAA Region 21 Regional Tournament Semifinal between the Northern Essex Knights and the Bristol Community College Bayhawks of Fall River. Hi, I'm David Cardoza. I'm joined alongside here with Mr. Andrew Augustus. Andrew, we have a big matchup today between the Bayhawks and between the Northern Essex Knights. Last week, you and I were in Boston. We were in good old Boston, Massachusetts at Bunker Hill Community College, where the Bayhawks' 11-game win streak was snapped in heartbreaking fashion against the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs. Their streak was snapped. Their hearts were broken last week in the state championship, a tournament that they desperately wanted to have. But they have a new lease on life because today, the same four teams are here for the regional tournament. If the Bayhawks win today and they win tomorrow, they're going to New York for the national tournament. Exciting stuff.
All eyes are on the Big Apple. It's kind of like deja vu, except with a longer drive for us today. But, it's going to be worth it.
A real long drive.
We came in, and when we first showed up, we got to see the second half for the Mass Bay Bunker Hill game. And it was very similar to last week. Bunker Hill with a big lead, let it choke it down the late, and ended up pulling off with the victory. And now we're coming here again, seeing the BCC Bayhawks playing against the Knights once again. So it's going to be interesting to see. What I'm looking forward to is to make sure they come out a lot stronger, a lot faster than they did last week. I think everyone can remember being down 3 points at the half was stunning. Completely outplaying Northern Essex in the first 20 minutes, and yet to be down by three is quite difficult. So now, if you're BCC, you just lost your 11-game win streak. You got to come out fast, you got to come out hard, but you got to come out disciplined. I think that was their big downfall last week in that championship game against Bunker Hill. So if they could come out and do what they did in the second half when they played this Northern Essex team, this should be just a rout, and we should have another rematch in the finals tomorrow.
Well, I think the theme of this weekend, Andrew, is redemption. It's all about redemption today. You can erase all your wrongs from last week. Coach Rob Del Lue had his team out last night for a team dinner. He got his team relaxed. And really, it's just kind of reset and reload kind of thing. Coming out here today, I think they're going to play much better basketball. I think that's just a guess of mine.
You have to look at it that way. I mean, every game throughout this season, I think, as we were talking about last week, this is a tale of two teams. In the first half of the season, they struggled playing about 500 basketball. 2016 rolls around. These guys were unbeatable up until they played at Bunker Hill last weekend. And you have to give credit to the Bulldogs in that situation. They were on their home court. They earned the right as the number one seed. They are the team to beat. But now we're on a neutral court here. This is no more home court advantage. We are in Springfield, but the Bayhawks can't start thinking about the Bulldogs right now. They need to focus on this Knight team, because as we see, if you take a team lightly, they're going to be up on you by three, and if you don't turn it around, you're out of here.
That's for sure. Last week we were in Boston, the home of champions, one of the greatest sports cities in the world today. Today we're in Springfield. It's the home of legends and the home of basketball Hall of Famers.
The one thing you definitely want to look for, and I think that tonight's key matchup, is going to be Gomes again. I mean, we can talk about Gerald all day, one of the top scorers in the country at his position. And last week, against this team, he only had 6 points in the first half. Turned it up in the second half, dropping 18. But what we need to see is for him to set the tone early. He is the kind of player that can take over a game, and as soon as he starts putting that ball in the basket, it can be Knights over. This team, as we see with the Knights, they only have 9 active players. You got to tire them out. You got to wear them out. You got to make them work for it. You tire them out, you come down the stretch, you will win this game.
Well, we know Coach Rob Del Lue, we know that he loves to go to his bench. He's got about 15 guys, and he's not afraid to use each and every single one of those guys. They like to wear you down. Do you think we'll see more of that pressing action today? Something that we've seen sparingly last weekend.
I think we might see a little more of it. I don't think in this game they will too much, because you don't need to press this team. You don't need to work them all running down back and forth. When I say you want to tire them out, you want to play smart basketball. You have a 30-second shot clock. BCC should not be taking shots until there's 10 seconds left in that shot clock. Pass it around, make them move, run some pick and rolls, and make the plays happen. And here, they have one big guy in Felix Moore, down low. You have so much more height than this team. I want you to see you work it down low, work it in the paint, easy layup.
Well, Coach Rob Del Lue, in his 8th season, he's never been to the national tournament to be held in New York. He has a shot to do it this weekend if the Bayhawks can pull out these two victories. Let's go down to the court. We're going to get ready for our starting lineups and player introductions.
Looks like it's going to be the same starters as last week for both teams. So really, no surprises here so far.
Yeah, this is perfectly deja vu. All four teams, same matchups.
That's all you need. I mean, if they can keep it easy on us like this the whole time, I will be a very happy man.
The Bayhawks with a win today would have a rematch tomorrow against Bunker Hill in the championship game at 3 p.m. How excited would that be after last week's loss in the state championship against Bunker Hill? How exciting to get Bunker Hill on a neutral court and those two teams battle it out again.
But here's the thing, you cannot start thinking about tomorrow yet. You need to focus on the here and the now, because if you start thinking about tomorrow's game, you're going to have a lot of mental lapses, and this game can get out of hand really quickly.
And that is for sure. We're getting ready for the tip-off here at Springfield Technical Community College, as the Bayhawks in their green, in their white uniform with the green trimming,
fans for both teams,
and in their royal blue, the Northern Essex Community College Knights. And we're getting set to tip off this regional tournament semifinal live from Springfield. All right, tipping off Baker. And Northern Essex gonna come away with it. Okay, 3-point shot, good. Okay, at the top of the key, driving to his right. Nelson gets into the lane, puts it up, and scores.
That's what you want to see, Nelson, drive into the lane, use that size. Again, as we talked about last week, this is a team, when you want to defend them, you need to have that perimeter defense up high. You cannot let this team get hot. Dominic Dar last week destroying it on the threes. I think he had six three-pointers
in that game. He was huge. And Josh Nelson gets the old-fashioned three-point play to tie this game right away. Here's good old Dominic, number one, being covered by Ephraim. Lynch, bounce pass, nice play to Brittle.
Nice little backdoor cut there by the Knights. Again,
nice find by Lynch.
You cannot let them get down low.
Here's Ephraim, driving strong to the hole, puts it up, no good. Looks like it's going to be off Northern Essex. No, it's going to be off the Bayhawks.
Yeah, it looks like Gomes got in there, tipped it away. Ephraim trying to do too much by himself on that motion. What he needs to do is kick that ball out, pass it off. Smart shots here.
Ball being brought up by Dior. Almost lost it there. With the ball, Lynch being covered by Cotton. Oh, nice block by Cotton.
Slow it
down,
Bayhawks
come away with the basketball.
These guys got to slow it down. Stop getting ahead of yourself. There you
Ephraim.
Go.
Ooh, Gomes looking good on the block there. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Northern Essex. Almost kills with the basketball there.
Continuation of last week. Can't make that ball find the hole.
Driving is Jameson. Loses control of it. Stolen by Baker. Jarrell Gomes up ahead. Careless pass.
Trying to force
Brittle
it.
Brittle finds Jameson down the other end. Puts it up off the glass and in. 7-3. And much like last week, Andrew, struggling out the gate of the Bayhawks.
Slow starts, that's not what you want to see.
Crossover. Nelson on the drive.
Nice find.
Gomes from the top, the three, no good.
I like the shot though, wide open, takes a shot, passing around. You do that, you can get those open shots, they will
Ooh,
fall.
Here's Dominic, a little hesitation, blocked by Gomes.
Nice block,
away
nice
with it
position.
Is Ephraim. Up ahead to Nelson, puts it up and lays it in.
Nelson responsible for all five Bayhawks points.
Good to see the Bayhawks push the basketball up court. Here's Jamison, driving to his left into the lane. Guarded by All World Gomes. Like to see the Bayhawks really get up on the perimeter and challenge these three-point shooting. And there's a three by Brittle, the trifecta. And just as I said that, a trifecta made by Brittle, 10-5 Knights. Gomes with the fake. Kicks it back out to Nelson. Nelson hesitating with that shot. He had the shot. Ephraim, he's unafraid to pull it. Being guarded by Lunch. 10 winding down on the shot clock. Here in the early going. 7 on the shot clock. From the elbow, Nelson, bad shot.
Got an offensive foul on Baker.
Offensive foul, yep. Offensive foul on number 14, Armani Baker. Ball's going to be going in the Knights' direction.
It looks like we got Joshua Banks and Jason Bing checking in. Bing having a big game last week against these Knights, so hopefully having him in down low will be able to change his momentum and cut this lead down.
And I'm surprised, Andrew, that he's not in the starting lineup today, given the fact that he did have a double-double. He had 21 points in that game. He was awesome. Surprised that he wasn't starting today.
Maybe good just to keep him on the bench, keep him fresh, let him be that spark plug.
Ooh, driving to the hole. Up and under. Going to get the foul. The foul's going to be on Jason Bing.
Very slow start for the Bayhawks.
That's for sure. At the line right now is Andres Hernandez. And he'll miss the first free throw. So much like last week, the slow start again by the Bayhawks, the Knights, with a similar start that they had last week. But as we've seen last week, Andrew, the Bayhawks, they can turn it on at any time. But they had a massive second half last week. Hopefully. Both free throws missed by Hernandez.
You got to make them. If you want to stay in a game at this level, you need to hit your free throws.
That's for sure, especially when it gets down to the nitty-gritty. Again, the shot clock winding down. Bayhawks having trouble with the Northern Essex defense. Gomes with a smaller Dior on him. Crossing over into the lane, kicks it back out. 4 on the shot clock, Ephraim for 3, gets it to go.
Great play there.
Jeremiah Ephraim.
That's what the Bayhawks need to do. Once Ephraim gets hot, this game can be over really quick.
There's a three-pointer by Brito. Leaves the hand up. Short.
Heat check.
Oh, goodness. Cotton should have grabbed that rebound. And Northern Essex will have a new shot clock here. We're being live streamed right here on frmedia.org. Here's Jamison. They swing it to Jamison. Jamison driving to his right. Buries his head in there, but knocked away by Gomes.
Nice job there. Staying
nice
strong.
Play by Gomes. Ephraim.
There we go. Pass it around. That's what I like to see.
Good to see them not forcing it. Good to see them being a little bit more patient with the basketball. Cotton spins in the lane. Loses out of bounds. Going to be knocked away by Mr. Lunch.
Lynch.
It is Lynch.
It
Remember
is Lynch.
Last week you said Lunch.
Hey, that's...
All right.
That was my mistake on the
writing. And I knew it was Lynch.
You were right.
But, you know, when it's on paper and it says Lunch, sometimes you get a roll with it. Inbounded is Jarrell Gomes underneath his own basket. Going to be almost 5 seconds there.
Taking
Gets
his
the
time.
Ball out to Ephraim from the top. We have a whistle. Ball's going to stay in this end. We're not sure what the call is.
I don't think the clock started.
Okay, so the clock never started. Kevin Desire, number 23, in for the Bayhawks.
Oh, now we're having
technical issues here at the Technical Community College.
So the way
we'll figure.
The way it was, the shot clock never started when the ball was inbounded. 2 seconds went off before they called it dead. So that's there we go.
Ephraim got room. Finds Nelson out there for 3. No good.
Got to get that rebound, guys.
Lynch pushing it up for Northern Essex. Puts it around the back. To a cutting. Hernandez puts it up over Bing. Can't get it to go. Gets his own rebound. New shot clock for the Knights.
Yeah, you just saw Desire there kind of step his foot out as he was trying to go baseline. Gets the block. Easy call.
Got to get position. You got to get over there. Got to slide those feet.
The Bayhawks, I don't understand. After watching them play Northern Essex last week, they were very disciplined. Now, these past two games, they seem to be fouling a lot, which is not a good
Jameson
sign.
Jameson for three, no good. Up high for the rebound is Jarrell Gomes. Nice inbounds play. They had the shot that they wanted. Couldn't get it to go.
Big and strong there by Gomes down low. That's what you need.
Here's Jarrell Gomes. Out to Nelson. Nelson had three. Puts it up. Goes to the lane. Can't get it to go. Nice move there by Nelson with the up fake, but couldn't get it to drop. Dominic Dar kicks it back out to Lynch.
That's
thought
a
about
travel.
Three. It's going to be steps.
Man, I even saw that one, and I don't even know what a travel is anymore.
Yeah, he was tripping over his own feet there.
Kind of like did a little sidestep shuffle.
A little sidestep shuffle. You know, I'm looking at the big three right now. Jarrell Gomes, Jeremiah Ephraim, and Josh Nelson, the Triple J's. Those going to be the catalyst for today's game for the Bayhawks.
Definitely. These guys can score at a moment's notice, so hopefully they can start putting that ball in the basket. Still down two.
We're here on the early going. Oh, Gomes, I'm not sure where he was going with that pass. He was trying to get it to Tejada. Telegraphed that one. Brito, coast to coast, puts it up and lays it in. Kevin Brito with a strong first 6 minutes for the Northern Essex Knights. If you're just joining us, 12-8 here. Going to the hole is Ephraim. He's going to get fouled, and I believe he will go to the line for two. Or is it on the floor? No, he'll go to the line.
He was in the shooting motion. That foul was on Lynch, his first, team second.
Get a cool breeze in here. It feels good.
That's nice.
Yeah, it's nice.
The AC units are working. It's good to see Ephraim hitting these free throws. Last week in the championship game, struggling mightily. But it looks like he's found his touch again.
I guarantee Rob Dale Lou had him and the whole team working on their free throws. These free throws, so big down the stretch. Dominic Dar in the lane to a cutting Lynch. Misses it. Going the other way. Nelson.
Man, he missed
Nelson doesn't have the numbers, but he's going to get in the lane. Woo. Gets it to go in.
Nelson taking over right now. That is 7 points for him early on.
12-12, we're tied.
Bayhawks have yet to hold a lead.
Kevin Brito. Had the upfake by Gomes.
That was a great block by Nelson, who overjumped the upfake, but still was able to come down and make contact with just the ball.
Great play for sure. Gomes has a smaller door on him. Nelson for three. No good. Way off. Rebounded by Lynch. Pushing in is Dominic Dar. Haven't seen Dominic Dar dominate like the way we've seen him last week. They're all over him. Lynch, nice fake. Pass goes past Desire, and gets it to go.
Then he gets
a steal. He steals the inbound pass from Ephraim.
This is what happens.
And Lynch.
You stop thinking. You get sloppy. Keep your head open, guys. You can't stop losing concentration.
Getting way too cocky. Getting way too lackadaisical, complacent. Tejada from the elbow makes the shot. Nice shot by Mikel Tejada. That was big. Timeout on the floor. 16-14. Timeout on the floor by the Bayhawks. At 16-14, what do you see here in this early going?
Mental lapses. I think that's the only way I can explain it. Like, this Bayhawk team does not look hungry. The Knights are hungry. They're crashing the basket. They're moving that ball around. They're making quick, smart decisions, really not getting in their own way. You just saw Lynch drive up, gets the easy lay-in. So we saw this happen last week. A quick inbound, not paying attention, turns around, swipes away, gives them another 2 points.
And this is
mistakes like this are what's going to affect you in the long term. You might be able, against a team like the Knights right now, to be get away with it. But if you expect to beat the Bulldogs, you cannot have any of those mistakes like you had last week. And this is, I would say, a disappointing start. And coach cannot be happy right now with the guys.
And this is uncharacteristic of a Rob Dale Lou team. You would figure after last week's show it against the Knights, you know, after they got off to a slow start, they were kind of sluggish. You figured his team would come out running and gunning. And we haven't seen any of that press today. We haven't seen any of that sense of urgency. This is the regional tournament. This is where champions are made. If you want to get to New York, you're going to start playing your best basketball, and it has to start right now.
if you don't win this game, you're going home. And I hope these kids realize that.
Kevin Brito being guarded by Ephraim. Out of the timeout, 12 minute up, coming up on 12 minutes to play. Jamison swings it in the corner to Trace. Back up to Dominic Dorr. Swinging it around the perimeter. The big man, Felix Moore, going against Jason Bing. Bing putting his hands up. Moore can't get it to go, can't find the rim.
Oh, they're calling it a jump ball, but still going to be Bayhawks possession.
Possession arrow going in the Bayhawks' favor.
I still think that should have been a shot clock violation. The ball never touched rim. Arm went off, the buzzer went off almost the same time the refs called it. But possession's possession.
Ephraim finds Gomes. I'm not sure why Gomes doesn't just take his man. He's got a smaller guy on him. Rebounded by Tejada, gets his own rebound. Kicked it back out for a new shot clock.
It's an interesting matchup.
Gomes needs to take him.
You got to hold. Looks like Gomes got bailed out there. The foul is on Dar, his first, team third.
Gomes runs about 6'3", 6'4". I mean, Dominic Dorr is 5'7 at best, and he should be dominant. He should be dominating him.
I'm 5'10", and I think I have a good 4 or 5 inches on him. 5'7", maybe generous.
Yeah. Northern Essex in man-to-man. They've been playing good man-to-man today. Gomes swoops up for three, gets it to go. 1, 2, 3, Gomes. And just like that, the Bayhawks take the lead. Maybe that could catapult them.
First lead of the day.
They get it down to Felix Moore. Reverse. It's going to be
double dribble.
Double dribble.
You can't put.
How
both
did he double dribble?
When he went around to cut baseline, it looked like he took both of his hands and
slammed and slammed it.
Did a double slam. You can't do that. Pick a hand, left or right. Can't do both.
Well, sometimes in the paint they say you can do that.
No.
Or get away with it at least. Here's Gomes on the wing being guarded by Dorr. That's the matchup right now. Nelson.
I think they like Dar's quickness, but it's.
Oh, Nelson.
Giving up a lot in the height department.
Nelson on the drive, trying to get it to Baker, throws it out of bounds.
You got to keep your head up. You got to make smarter passes. A lot of unforced errors right now, which is very frustrating if you coach Rob DeLue.
It's got to be very frustrating, but thus they have the lead. It doesn't have to be pretty. It's just survive in advance.
Nice tip there. Nice save by Cotton.
Survive in advance. I think the great Jim Valvano, that was one of his monikers. Ephraim, going to his right, flips it up to Baker in the lane with a finger roll, gets it to go.
That was pretty.
Pretty pass, pretty lay-in by Baker there, the pass by Ephraim. And it's 19-16. Mini run by the Bayhawks now. Ooh, inside to Trace, misses it. Rebounded by Nelson. Nice pass there on the lane, but the layup was no good. Nelson coming up out of control.
Had to throw it up.
Rebounded by Baker.
Oh, we got a foul on the floor.
The foul is going to be on Felix Moore, number 33, the big man. You're getting some props over here.
Yeah, we tried to do a good job.
Alex Cotton from the elbow. That's his shot. Gets it to go. Number 12.
This is what we like to see.
The sophomore, Alex Cotton, with the shot from the elbow. 21-16. Bayhawks in a little mini run here. A 7-0 run. Ooh.
Here we go. You start making these guys frustrated, you're going to win this game no problem.
We have some substitutions. Have some substitutions for the Bayhawks. Trace Schaub back up to Dominic Dorr. NBA range three, way up the side of the rim. Rebounded by Brito. Gets his own rebound, kicks it back out to Dorr.
Unacceptable.
Swings it in the corner for Schaub. Three, no good. Rebounded by Mr. Jarrell Gomes.
No shot, but we have a foul on the floor. Number four.
Okay, so let's get our substitutions in the game now for the Bayhawks with the blonde hair. Number two, Josh Banks. And also
a lot
number
of new
three.
Hairstyles this week.
And also, yeah, also throwing you off. And also number three, Ray Perez in the game. Oh, and now coming in is Jeremiah Ephraim coming in for Josh Banks. So Alex Cotton, Jeremiah Ephraim, Armani Baker, Perez, and Jarrell Gomes out there for the Bayhawks. Ooh. Gomes got away with a pass there. Full shot clock now for the Bayhawks. Gomes. Up and under against his man Dorr, gets his own rebound. Nice hustle there.
Nice shot by
rebound
Baker.
Rebound by Baker, cleans it up, no good. Keeps it alive. Cotton is there. Tipped by Baker.
Does anybody want to score a basket?
Goodness gracious. Several opportunities there for the Bayhawks. They can't get it to drop in. Goodness gracious. Matthew Lynch. I don't know how we got through the lane there. My goodness. Matthew Lynch there with a nice basket.
After having seven attempts down there, one miracle shot by Lynch, and it's a three-point game.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Ephraim up over Moore. Nothing doing.
Stepped out of bounds.
Oh, stepping out of bounds.
I think what happened was he saved it inbounds, and then he stepped out of bounds, and then he was the first one to touch it coming back inbounds. That's out of bounds.
Good observation. 21-18. 8 minutes and 22 seconds left in this first half. Nice lob pass into Baker, and he's going to get fouled.
Let him finish.
Great job by Gomes to spot a cutting Baker going to the lane on the inbound pass. And Baker, even though he's undersized as a forward, he does a lot of gritty work. He gets the ball on the baseline. He gets offensive rebounds. He can get dirty and nasty under there for a guy his size. That's his area in the paint. He does a good job of it.
He plays strong, and he may not have a lot of muscle on him, but he gets the shooter's roll there for the first one. But he can stand his own, which is very important coming down low, especially playing in that forward spot where you need to get these rebounds, especially against a team like this.
Well, he just finds a way. He wants it more, even though being undersized. I mean, he's a guy that goes in there and can mix it up with anybody. Loves to get the ball on the baseline there and has a strong move there. And like I said, he can just mix it up with anybody and he can leap. Baker hits the second free throw. 5-point lead now for the Bayhawks. So maybe we're seeing the Bayhawks hitting their stride, getting their mojo going.
This is what we want to see. Start extending this lead.
Dominic Dara yet with a field goal. Ooh, going to lane. Number three, nice drop pass to Andres Hernandez. Hernandez gets his own rebound, puts it up the glass, and he'll get it to go on the second opportunity.
His first points of the day.
First points for Andres Hernandez. Here's Perez with the basketball. Perez did a good job as a backup point last week in Boston. Nelson gets it down low to Gomes. That's a matchup they got to exploit.
Pass.
Perez for three, no good. Had a good look. Baker, there's the guy. And he'll get to the free throw line.
The beautiful pass there by Gomes, realizing he probably could have tried to do something fancy, throw it up. Sees a wide open Perez, puts up a great shot, just rims out. Great strong rebound by Baker to put it right back up. Gets fouled, shooting two more.
And this is where Baker usually finds himself because of the gritty hard work that he does, the blue collar work that he does on the interior.
That's the first Bayhawks free throw miss of the game, which is a lot better than last week.
Is it their first miss?
That was their first free throw miss.
I thought he missed the front end last time.
No, he didn't. It bounced up and went in. Shooter's touch.
Okay. Second free throw. Second free throw made by Baker. And it's a 4-point lead. Perez going after the ball.
Oh.
Going to be some steps. Steps by Brito. Going back the other way.
You know it's bad when your coach doesn't even try to argue, like even put his hands up, like, really, that was a travel? Like, yeah. you messed up there, kid.
Yeah. Definitely some obvious travels that we've seen. The Knights stole it a man-to-man. Jameson covering Nelson. Baker thought about setting the pick. Ephraim got such great dribble moves. Puts it up on the glass. He got tipped by Brito a little bit. And it's going to be off Brito and go out of bounds.
Fortunate there for the Knights that it did not hit the rim and that they didn't come down with possession of it and dribbled it off his foot. Shot clock at 11.
Ephraim looking inbound. Gets it inside to Baker. Baker turning to his right. Puts it up off the puts it up off the rim and inside. Nice little hook shot by Baker. 26-20. Kevin Brito got off to a hot start for the Knights. Been kind of cool lately. I love the zone, the way that it's working. Dar, oh, the Dar with a three. It's a three. Dominic Dar with his first three of the game. And just like that, it's 26-23. They've been kind of keeping him in check after he hit seven threes last week. That's his first of today. Again, that man-to-man getting to the Bayhawks, forcing them to run down the shot clock. Perez loses the basketball. Gets it back. Perez darting towards the lane, and he's going to get the contact and go to the line.
Perez kind of trying to go fancy behind the back, loses possession of it.
But a good hustle by him to get the basketball back, make a beeline towards the basket, have the wherewithal to get to the contact, and he's going to be going to the line for two.
Definitely a very close call. Very close to being backcourt. I think it was about inches away if he touched it a little bit earlier. But luckily the refs decided he was not a backcourt violation. And he hits the first one.
6:14 left to play here in the first half from Springfield. Springfield Technical Community College, the site of the regional tournament for Region 21 NJCAA action here on FR Media. I'm David Cardoza. I'm alongside here with Andrew Augusta, AA himself.
Perez missing the shot. I always find that funny. When a player is supposed to get subbed in and he misses the second one, the guy's coming in for the shooter. Maybe he just wants to stay in the game a little longer.
Maybe it's a deep three by Ephraim. Front rims it, no good. Long rebound out to Jameson. Back to Dar. Dar looking to push. Ooh, Dar swoops to the lane, up and under. Gets it to go, rolls it in. Dar showing his speed as he goes and drives the lane. Goes the length of the court, coast to coast.
I'm sorry, no man that short should be able to get under the basket like that.
No, that's a couple times that Northern Essex Knights players have just driven the lane, going through the Bayhawks defense like Swiss cheese. Unbelievable. Nelson driving on Jameson. Flips it under to Baker. Can't get it to go. Back goes Dar. Dar going through the lane. Up, puts it up off the glass. No good. Nelson pushing it up to Tejada. Tejada looking to go for the layup.
Charge.
And it's going to be offensive foul. Good job by Jameson to get there, plant himself, and get the contact, get the charge.
He was there for a while. That's a very good charge call.
Back to Dominic Dar. You know, Dominic Dar, like, he's very fast. Doesn't look fast, but he's just very quick. And somehow, he does a great job of shading his body because he, Schaub.
Why the
goes
heck
the baseline.
Baker,
no good.
Why is Baker biting on a terrible pump fake attempt? He didn't even bring the ball up. He was dribbling it.
Tell me how you pronounce his name, because I keep calling him Schaub, like he's Matthew Schaub.
Let's see.
Trace? Shaby.
Shageby.
Dominic Dorr driving to his right, flips it to Jameson underneath. Nice play. Nice penetration going baseline. Dorr to drop it up to Jameson, and we're tied at 27. Banks. Going to drop it in. This is the matchup he should be taking care of. Turnaround jumper, no good by Gomes.
Getting an eerie feeling. Game's tied, 4:35 to play, and you've outplayed them this first half. What has happened?
Ooh, Jameson going baseline. Ooh. And the foul looks like it's going to be on Baker. Baker holding his face.
His second.
Second foul on Armani Baker, as you said. Brito gets it out of the corner. Jameson thought about a deep three on Banks. Dorr. Shavesby kicks it back out to Jameson. They swing it to a corner for Brito for the three. No good. Tipped up. And it's going to be going Bayhawks' way.
Second foul on Brito.
4 minutes and 16 seconds left. Deadlocked at 27. In last week's game against Northern Essex in the state championships at Bunker Hill, the Bayhawks exploded in the second half. 64-27 they outscored the Knights. So we know it's 27-27 now. It's tied. It's anybody's game. But the Bayhawks, they can come out in the second half and they can explode. Ooh, rebounded by Bing off the rebound.
How is that not a
off
foul?
Off the free throw.
Too.
Jason Bing finally gets on the scoreboard for the Bayhawks.
How is that not a foul on Jameson? He's like backing him up.
Bayhawks starting to swarm with that zone. Lynch loses the basketball. Recovered by Jarrell Gomes. Jarrell Gomes sporting a new hairstyle today, as is Banks. Ooh, Gomes on the elbow. No good. Off the side of the rim. And rebounded by Ephraim. They're going to start a new 24, new
30.
New shot clock. New 30. Gomes on the block. Being covered by Dar. Help defense by the Knights. Nothing doing though. As Gomes will lay it in. Going back the other way. Dar throws it out of bounds. Bayhawks basketball. So just as the Knights climb back into this one, tie the score at 27. Bayhawks on consecutive trips down the floor. Get the score to 4. Plus 4.
Need to extend this lead. You need to have a double-digit lead by half.
Oh, nice bounce pass by Ephraim inside to Gomes. Nice pass there through the Northern Essex defense. And just like that, they're up by 6.
When these guys start sharing the ball, they're a much better team.
You definitely got that right. Driving to us right as Lynch. Gets it back up to Hernandez. Shaysby for 3. Good. Nothing but net. Pretty shot by Trey Shaysby.
And
cuts the lead to 33-30 with 2 minutes and 49 seconds here in Springfield.
This is exactly what happened last week. About 5 minutes, close game. The Bayhawks start to pull away. Knights start scrounging back with a couple of threes. Next thing we know, final buzzer rings. We're down by 3.5.
That's for sure. And you talk about the Bayhawks and how when they share the basketball, when they're moving the ball around the perimeter, when they're moving and shifting the opposing team's defenses, they're a much better team than when they go ISO and when they just, you could tell when they look all out of sorts. They're going isolation. They're not running their plays. Their plays are only, their shots, their play selection is only going through a couple of players. When everybody's touching the basketball on the offensive end, when they're moving the basketball and being unselfish, that's when they're playing their best basketball. That's how they went on an 11-game win streak. They got cut short last week in the final against Bunker Hill. They played a different brand of basketball the second half of the season.
It was incredible to watch, and I mean, especially last weekend where you started to see, and especially in the second half against this Knight team, 3, 4, 5 passes before anyone even made an attempt to get to the basket. That's the way you beat this team. You pass it around, lanes will open, then you take advantage of the lanes and you go in.
Keep the defense on their toes. You got to keep their defense on their toes. The Bayhawks are the more athletic team, top to bottom. They're the deeper team, they're the more athletic team, they're the more explosive team. But right now, it's just a 33-30 game here in the first half. Regional tournament semifinal, the second game today here at Springfield Technical Community College on the men's side. Nelson ran into Lynch, somehow flips it up off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Gomes, trying to power it up, he does.
Nelson's going to be careful there. Could get called for a push-off soon.
But Gomes gets the offensive board and puts it up in. 5-point lead. Trey Shaysby, cross-court to Lynch. Lynch driving to his left. Again, puts it up. And it's going to be a block. Blocking foul called on Jason Bing.
I think Bing's feet were right in the circle. So gets there about a half second earlier and a half step higher up. That's a charge.
Yeah, he was way too deep there. Way too deep there in the paint for that to be called a charge. So Lynch will go to the line for 2. We haven't talked too much about the foul situation right now. Both teams are in the bonus. Both teams are in the one-on-ones. Lynch will miss the free throw.
Cotton checking back in for Bing, who has 2. Now, this is interesting. Last week, we saw Felix Moore come in to cover Bing. Now it looks like Moore's going to come in to cover Cotton.
That's kind of weird because Felix Moore and Jason Bing, that's kind of more of the matchup right there. Cotton giving up a lot of size, a lot of weight to Mr. Felix Moore. Second free throw, good. My Mr. Matthew Lynch. Here's Jeremiah Ephraim, 2 minutes left. Bayhawks being patient, that's what you like to see. If you're Bayhawks Nation out there. Nelson, covered by Jameson. Oh, Nelson tried to get a bounce pass over to Banks, but he telegraphed it. Lynch tried to go behind the back. Somehow Moore comes up with it, puts up an off crazy shot off
Come on,
the glass.
Ephraim's going to go on the floor. In that situation, there is no way Moore should be getting that ball instead of Ephraim. Ephraim's a lot quicker, a lot more agile. He needs to be diving on the floor to get that ball.
No doubt about that. It's going to be blood, sweat, and tears at this point. You lose here, you go home. Northern Essex still playing man-to-man. There's Ephraim. The shot, no good. Rebounded by Lynch. Lynch coming away with a lot of rebounds. Dominic Darr, Moore, twisted out to Schaub in the corner for three, no good. Lynch went high up for that one, no good though. I mean, nothing doing. Here's Ephraim, the jumper,
nice
it's
shot.
Good. Jumper from the side, from the elbow was good. 6-point lead, Bayhawks have pretty much controlled this basketball game here in the last 10 minutes or so.
They gotta keep it up, no time to get complacent.
Darr, Lynch, fakes a three, back to Darr for three. No good, rolls out, rebounded by Gomes. Gomes looking to push. He'll slow it down. Gomes pulls up for three. Going to be short. Darr gets it. Darr going all the way. Gomes waiting for him at the paint. The dish to Lynch. Nice block by Josh Nelson.
Nice block there. Big. That just shows the athleticism of Nelson to be able to get up there and make a block on Lynch after a nice pass by Darr.
It seems as though Nelson wasn't even the picture, but he went up and got a heck of a block there. Darr calls out the play. Schaub in the corner for three. Loves that shot, but no good. Gomes ahead to Ephraim. Waiting for him is Jameson, but he'll go over him. No. Misses the layup. Moore with the rebound. 30 seconds left in the first half. 22 on the shot clock. It's a 4-second differential. Lynch back out to Darr. They're going to pretty much try to hold this for the last shot here. Lynch in the lane to Moore. Moore. Ooh, he had him. Definitely had him. Oh, coming in his Darr and misses it. Rebounded by Nelson. By Gomes. They'll have a shot for the last shot here. Ephraim for three in the corner. No good. Rebounded by Josh Nelson.
And
I'll tell you what, Josh Nelson.
Back.
I'll tell you what, with Josh Nelson and Jarrell Gomes, kind of similar hairstyles today. Kind of throwing me off with the headband. And the
koosh ball?
The koosh ball, like you said earlier.
I miss my koosh basketball set.
I bet you do. Was it like a My Little Pony one or something like that?
No, it was purple and green.
Exactly, My Little Pony.
That wasn't My Little Pony whatsoever. First shot's good.
Josh Nelson hits the first free throw. Bayhawks up by 7. Bayhawks up by 8. 2/10 of a second left. They're going to inbound. That wouldn't count. Nice.
He got it on target.
Dominic
Darr
looking like he could be a quarterback there with a left-handed throw.
Yeah, the one thing notice a little rough between Cotton and Moore. It looks like Cotton ended up on the floor at the end of that break that led to the Nelson free throws. But for the Bayhawks to have an 8-point lead, they should be very happy right now.
Well, it was definitely a resurgence. They were down. They found themselves down 16-14 after that. After that, they made a three-pointer, and they never looked back since. Ever since 16-14, they have not looked back. It was tied 27-27, but pretty much from that point, 16-14, when they took the lead, they have not looked back since. So right now, 39-31, live streaming here on FR Media. 39-31, your Bristol Community College Bayhawks have the lead right now at the half. In this regional tournament semifinal game, NJCAA Region 21, David Cardoza and Mr. Andrew Augustin on the call. It's halftime. We'll be right back after this. Congratulations. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Springfield Technical Community College here in the good old city of Springfield, Massachusetts, where the Bristol Community College Bayhawks lead the Northern Essex Knights, Community College Knights, 39-31 here at the half. So a slow start for the Bayhawks. Slow start, sluggish start, much like last week.
At least they have the lead this time.
At least they have the lead this time. Another sluggish start. But from the time it was 16-14, almost midway through the first half, the Northern Essex Knights had the lead 16-14. After that, the Bayhawks hit a three-pointer, and they haven't trailed ever since that point in the game, and now it's 39-31, and the Bayhawks really controlled that game in the second half. What do the Bayhawks need to do to close this team out to get to the final for tomorrow?
They need to keep this momentum up. Jarrell Gomes leading the way, 12 points, and that's what I said in the pregame. He needs to set the tone and set the tone early. Started off a little slow, but once he started picking up, really dominating down low, he's going up against Dominic Dar. Jarrell Gomes, 6'3", 6'4". Dominic Dar, 5'2", on a good day. Probably more like 5'5". But still, there's such a big height difference between the two. This is where Gomes is a great perimeter shooter. Needs to drive it in, back him up. Easy spin move, float it in. He can get points all day. Besides that, this Bayhawks team, I've been saying it since last week, they need to keep it doing. Pass the ball around, create lanes. You do that, you will get the open player and have easy lanes, and you'll be able to run away with this game in the second half.
Are you surprised that in the first half, Jason Bing wasn't used more? We've seen Jason Bing dominate this team. Northern Essex has a lack of height. Are you surprised that we haven't seen much of Jason Bing and Kevin Desire, two of the bigger guys for the Bayhawks?
I mean, yes, because of the height difference, but they're not needed right now. Last week, they were needed. They were down three at half, and they needed to come out with a bigger lineup. Now you can
they were kind of the surprise stars last week,
yeah,
Jason Bing.
And now you have to give them a more of a relaxed standpoint. Let them rest up. Don't really rush them too hard, because we saw this last week. These guys can play physical, and they can rough and get in your head. You got to keep that mental aspect in there. So why are you going to send the guy in down low where you have an eight-point lead now? If the game gets close and they start to get within 3-2, maybe you'll see Desire and Bing come back in. But now let the smaller lineup do it. Work them out. Tire them out, because if there's a team that can get tired, it's this Knight team with only going 9 deep.
Well, here are some of the leading scorers for both sides. Here are the top couple players for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. We have there
Jarrell Gomes with 12, Josh Nelson
with 9. No surprise there.
9, and then a kind of nice little surprise, Amani Baker putting some points in, getting 7, the top three scorers for the Bayhawks. On the Knight side, I think you and I are both shocked just to see Kevin Brittle with 10 points already. I mean, starting off hot, a couple threes, a couple twos, really setting the tone early. And the surprise is Dar's only got 5, and the big man Moore, 0. So if they can keep these numbers as down as they are, the Bayhawks should be cruising into a rematch with the Bulldogs tomorrow.
Even though Northern Essex has had their threes, it seems like the Bayhawks are more in tune with actually guarding the perimeter this time. It seemed like last week the Knights had a lot of open looks. That's why Dominic Dar had about 7 threes in that game, because he had so many open looks. They're keying in on him this time.
He's missed a couple, and that's not going to stay the same. If you keep giving him open looks, he will start hitting them. So right now, if you are the Bayhawks, you need to come out with a strong perimeter defense and get ready to dominate this second half on the outside. If they want to try to go low, you have Cotton down low. You got Baker down low. They're not going to get in there any chance. So keep that perimeter protected. Give the one-on-one matchups down low. You're going to win this game.
Well, we're getting ready for second half action here live from Springfield Technical Community College. Inbounding is Northern Essex. Bayhawks coming out in their 2-3 zone. They get in the corner to Lynch. Down inside. Ooh. Nice interior passing there by Northern Essex. Brittle comes away with it. Can't lay it up and in. Rebounded by Cotton. Cotton on the wing to Gomes.
That's unacceptable to have Brittle that open to get such an easy put up. That's unexcusable this early.
Driving to his right. Nelson kicks it back out to Cotton.
Travel.
And
stepped out of bounds.
They say that he stepped on the sideline over there.
Yeah, his left foot kind of looked a little back, touched the maroon line, out of bounds, turnover. Knights ball.
Here comes Dominic Dar. Love the way Dominic Dar plays the game. Seems like a very, very much the leader of this basketball team. Kevin Brito kicks it back out. Hernandez back out to Dar for 3. No good.
Can't let him get that
another
open.
Another miss. Ooh, Dar saves that one. Jamison with the basketball. New shot clock for Northern Essex. Driving to his right.
Foul on Baker on the floor, and that's his third, so you're going to see probably Bing coming in really soon.
Bing at the end of the bench there, lacing up his boots, lacing up his sneakers. Inbound underneath their own basket. There's Northern Essex. Jameson, ooh, thought about the three, and then Nelson runs into him. Northern Essex bench likes it.
Can't be having these fouls early, guys. These are going to add up. You're going to send them to the line. It's going to make this game closer than it should be.
Jameson back out to Brito. Brito and Dar in the backcourt. Ooh, nice pass to Hernandez. Oh. Nice block. Nice block by Baker getting up there. But coming up with Hernandez, and Northern Essex is going to retain possession here. After a great defensive play by Armani Baker in the paint.
This, yeah, you are the taller team. You're the stronger team. How are they getting offensive rebounds?
Dar picks up his throw. There's going to be steps. Dar didn't know if he wanted to get into the paint or kick it back out. He was kind of in the middle of a decision there. We have a timeout on the court.
A minute and a half has gone by in this half, and exactly 0 points have been scored.
From either team.
I don't even think the Bayhawks have had a shot.
No, they haven't.
You can't go 90 seconds in the second half without a shot.
That was the quickest 90 seconds I've ever seen.
Coach Rob needs to wake these kids up. Like, I get it. You might be a little tired. You kind of relaxed after an 8-point lead, but that is unacceptable right now.
You can't relax with an 8-point lead. We've seen a lot of leads go down the toilet, you know, in a flash in these games, especially in Bayhawks games. So 39-31, we'll keep it here. 18 minutes and 28 seconds left. Winner of today's game will face Bunker Hill Community College in tomorrow's championship game, regional championship for Region 21. The winner of that goes on to the Nationals in New York. So a lot on the line, a lot at stake, high stakes here. These two teams faced each other last week in Boston. And the Bristol Community College Bayhawks were winners last week against this very Northern Essex Knights team, 109-75. They blew them out.
I may be wrong, but I think Jason Bing changed his shoes. I thought he was wearing gray ones, and now he's wearing black ones.
Well, maybe those are the shoes. Maybe those are the lucky shoes.
Come alive in the second half.
Northern Essex sticking with that man-to-man. Very impressed how they stuck with that. Jameson, they feel they can match up with these guys. Gomes.
Oh, I got to have a better pass.
Nelson spins in the lane. Puts it up with the left hand. Nice, pretty move by Josh Nelson. Spinning in the lane and putting up with his left hand. So athletic.
Bayhawks shooting 100% this half.
Jameson makes extra pass.
Everyone forgets that maroon line. You see, a lot of the courts have like the very
that
thin
white
line.
Yeah,
this
white
is a long one. So it's like, maybe I could. Nope. As soon as that gets maroon, you are out of bounds. Don't forget that.
Well, sometimes you see that white stripe. Cotton. Almost lost that one. Ooh, Ephraim decides to shoot. Air ball. Saved by Nelson. Nice kick out.
10 seconds, guys. Got to work it around.
Hit on the shot clock. Nelson has Cotton in the post. Decides to get it to Gomes. Four on the shot clock. Driving to his left. Oh, try to get it to Baker, and it's stolen by Brito.
I don't know what Ephraim was thinking taking that shot.
Gomes making a few bad passes today. Ooh, nice drive by Jameson. Driving to his left and putting it up with his right. Score it. Score for number 10, Matthew Jameson. Bounce pass from Ephraim. Gomes. To Nelson at the top.
Stutter step.
Bayhawks offense finally moving, and Ephraim gets in the lane, puts it off the window and in. Nice move by Jeremiah Ephraim.
Nice little stutter side.
Yeah, when he's going to the basket, good things happen. Ooh. Matthew Lynch is so sneaky with the basketball.
How is that? Come on. How are you going to give him shots for that? He's still got three more steps to take before he even throws it up.
It's unbelievable.
Foul is on the floor. It was a foul, but it was on the floor.
But isn't it unbelievable how he's able to get by defenders? He doesn't seem overly fleet of foot, and he just sneaks by defenders, and somehow he's just deceptively quick.
Ball don't lie. That ball knew he didn't deserve to be at the free throw line. That's why it didn't go in. If he misses this one, I'm just going to say, hey.
The basketball gods are honest. Armani Baker and Alex Cotton checking out for the Bayhawks. Coming in for the Bayhawks is sophomore Steven Gonzalez. And Jason Bing. Big man Jason Bing. Both free throws missed, so you're right. 43-33, Bayhawks with the lead. Nelson around the back. Loses control of it. Now Lynch goes around his back. Going in the lane, puts it up, trying to go with the right hand. That seems to be his bread and butter, but he misses it. Ephraim, nice pass to Nelson. Blocked by Jameson. Now out to Lynch. Lynch loses control.
Smart move. Very smart move by Lynch to pull it out, slow things down, get a favorable matchup.
Jameson, back to Lynch.
Travel.
Steps. Lynch showing his steps, his feet can be too quick sometimes.
The feet were moving before the head. It happens once in a while.
That seems to be what it is with these travel calls. The feet start moving before the brain. Here's Gomes, number one, the top 10 scorer in the country. Sophomore sensation to Nelson. Ephraim back out to Nelson again. That man-to-man. Ooh, somehow putting it around his back. Puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Gonzalez. What a move by Gomes.
Good strong move there by Nelson and not let Dar break it away.
Bristol with a new shot clock. Gonzalez.
Oh, come
offensive,
on. He was
offensive
moving.
Foul. Gonzalez kind of dipped the shoulder there, though.
Just trying to make a move.
The defender sold it, that's for sure.
Come on, ref. He was sliding. But, hey, they've taken a lot more officiating courses for basketball than
that. We have 4 team fouls already for Northern Essex.
Well, Dominic, for the Bayhawks.
I'm sorry, for the Bayhawks.
The Bayhawks have the 14 fouls.
I'm sorry, for the Bayhawks. I'm sorry.
Northern Essex has 0.
They do. The big man, Felix Moore, trying to sneak it in there to Brito. But Dar is there for 3. Can't get it to go.
That's a foul.
And it's going to be a foul. Loose ball foul on Felix Moore. The big man coming in, almost burying Stephen Gonzalez.
It's like one of those coming in hot.
Oh, it's been a long day, a long drive for sure. Here's Jarrell Gomes being guarded. He's going to back in Dar. That's what he should be doing. Take advantage of the size.
Easy.
These guys love to go behind the back.
Stop being fancy. You be fancy, you make dumb mistakes, I get frustrated.
Ephraim pulls up from the elbow. No good. Rebounded by Brito.
Good shot there. He was open. Just couldn't get it to fall.
Brito going coast to coast. Puts it up. No good. But he's going to go to the free throw line. It's going to be 5 team fouls now on the Bayhawks.
That's his second.
Bayhawks need to watch out, need to keep their hands to themselves because they're going to find themselves in the bonus.
2 more fouls and they're shooting free throws and there's 15 minutes to go in this game.
Well, yeah, well, the Knights are going to be in the bonus, rather.
Good. Looks like the Knights are having the free throw struggles the Bayhawks were having last Sunday.
43-33. Second free throw is nothing but net.
2 for 7.
Here comes Jeremiah Ephraim. Ephraim back out to Nelson. Gomes. Gomes driving to his right. Pops from the elbow. No good. Front rims. Rebounded by Shobey. Ooh. Berto, you're trying to use the speed there. Moore, the big man, topples over Bing. And Bing finally gets a charge.
That's his 4th, too. That's a big foul.
Did you see Moore there? He tried to dip that shoulder and try to bury Bing.
Tried to bulldog him, just head down.
He tried to spear him. He thought he was Roman Reigns for a second.
And that's one player the Knights can't lose because then their size is gone.
Exactly. I'd like to see the Bayhawks get the ball into Jason Bing. Nelson looking for the big man. Out to Gomes. Northern Essex playing that furious man-to-man. They'll try to dump it into Try to dump it into the big man. He gets knocked away.
The Hernandez-Brito double team being effective on Bing. Wide open.
Jameson, he loves that shot right there. No good. Rebounded by the big man.
Can't be leaving open threes.
Jameson, an effective three-point shooter. Kind of struggling from out there today. Gomes in the corner for three. It's going to be short. Gomes can't find the mark again. Gomes going cold. How many points for Gomes?
He has 12 still.
Still 12.
There have only been seven combined points this half.
And Jarrell Gomes has missed all his opportunities, especially from the outside. Hasn't been able to find the bottom of the ocean. Bayhawks really slowing up the tempo. Nelson, guarded by Brito. He had the shot. Nelson always hesitating. He needs to take that shot.
Travel. That's what happens.
Gonna be steps.
You hesitate, you're gonna travel, and you're gonna make unforced errors.
And we talked about isolation basketball. We talked about poor shot selection. Josh Nelson always seems hesitation with that shot, and he seems to always have that.
On the outside shots.
On the outside shot.
He loves to take it into the lane. If that's your case, Josh, become a true point guard.
Brito for three, no good. High up for the rebound is Bing.
Easy.
Ooh, out to Ephraim. Brito went in for the steal. Was late to get there. Nelson brings it in. He's just hesitating with that shot. Needs to get rid of it quicker. That pass is going to be out of bounds. Tossed by number three. Angelo Pilato throws that one way out of bounds. 13 minutes here in the second half. You're just joining us, 43-34. We're being live streamed here on frmedia.org. Also, you can find this on FR Media, Channel 95, Comcast on your dial.
Nice cross-court pass.
Nice cross-court pass to Ephraim, keeping the ball moving. Again, shot clock winded down. Gomes goes through his legs, puts it up, and will get fouled and goes to the line.
That is the second, number 20, Trace. You gonna try it again?
Trace Shaby. I'm going with Shaby. I'm saying the J.
I'm not gonna say that. I'm gonna say it's Shageby.
Shageby. Shageby.
I could be wrong.
Could just stick with Trace.
Trace is probably our safest bet. Timeout called by Gomes.
So the Bayhawks will take a timeout here. They have a 10-point lead, but they're not playing particularly well. Only 5 points scored here by the Bayhawks, and only 3 points scored here by the Northern Essex Knights. So not a lot of scoring here in the first almost nearly 8 minutes of play. 8 total points scored here. It's been a poor second half. Been kind of slow, been kind of a lackadaisical, kind of walk the ball up the court kind of second half. Really hasn't been too exciting.
And if I'm the Bulldogs right now, I'm not scared of either of these teams. The way both of these guys are playing, no reason to put in fear. Now, if the Bayhawks can turn it up, maybe we can see something that we can have a conversation. But right now, the way the Bayhawks are playing, they need to step it up and step it up big.
And the Bayhawks don't look, I mean, going by their body language, they just look like they're just not into it.
They're just happy to be here. It's like a nice Saturday to play basketball. That's about it. No urgency, no fight.
No, it's only the regional tournament.
New York.
Andres Hernandez with a wild shot underneath. Rebounded by Bing. Gomes to push it up. Armani Baker gets it knocked away.
That was an angry slap by Brito. He came in almost like a full windup and just was lucky he made contact with the ball on that one. If he missed the ball, that could have been ugly.
Brito plays very good basketball on both ends. He's a very good basketball player. Underneath, strong is Armani Baker. Strong move. That's my man right there, number 1-4, Armani Baker, playing strong on the interior with his lack of size. Can't stress that enough. He's probably their best inside presence, I think.
Yeah, big man down low. If you can get someone with
Jameson
Bing's.
Swings it to Dar. Up fake. Cross court.
Open.
There's the shot for Brito. No good. Bing with the long rebound. Here's Josh Banks. to Gomes in transition, loses it out of bounds, going back Northern Essex way.
Slow it down, guys. I get you're getting excited. You have that possibility. That one, take a dribble on the ground, go underneath, kick it out. You have an open three.
Well, we haven't seen too much of the transition game here in the second half. The Bayhawks have really been walking the ball up, playing the half-court offense, which isn't their forte. They're at best when they're in transition, when they're making things happen. Going baseline. Jamison running into Bing. Not something that you want to do. Rebounded by Brito. Puts it up and in. Second chance points. Definitely not what you want. Gomes finally getting aggressive. Finally taking the little man to school. Turnaround jumper in the lane is good. 49-36. Both times, Jarrell Gomes. Jarrell Gomes needs to get tough with Dar. Brito loses it off his foot. Oh, nice pass. Drops it off to Hernandez. Can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Bing. Bing finally getting in there, getting some rebounds. Up to Perez. To the trailer, Bing. Bing. Got to get that ball up, big man. Gets it to go.
Big man dropping it in. Doing the hard work. And we get a timeout by the Knights.
As a big man, you don't want that ball hovering around your ankles so the little guys can get it. Bing finally able to get that ball up over his head. Drops it in for two. And as ugly as it's been, as improbable as it seems, with the way that things have gone here in the second half, the way that things have looked, it's been ugly. It's a freaking 15-point lead, 51-36. It hasn't been the best basketball play that you'll ever see. But the Bristol Community College Bayhawks lead 51-36 with 10 minutes and 51 seconds left to play. And it seems right now that the Bayhawks have this one in control, Andrew. With 10 minutes and 51 seconds left, you know, I know you said earlier you don't want to look ahead to your opponent tomorrow. And I know that you said that Bunker Hill should not be scared of either of this team. I think Bristol is just kind of bored with Northern Essex right now, to tell you the truth.
I honestly think they came in with the mindset of we're playing Bunker Hill tomorrow, just by how they're playing. There's really no hunger in this game. There's really no drive in this game. And if that's the case, I hope I'm right, because then we're going to see a much hungrier team tomorrow.
I think you are definitely right.
But as of right now, if we're looking at the more hungry team, it's the Knights. And they're just trying, they're fighting, they're scrapping, but they just don't have the ability. And I think the injury, we were talking about it before the pregame even started. Jonathan Paulino is on the bench right now in crutches and a boot, and that's a big loss for them. He had a lot of their points, and he really set the drive, which caused Dar. I think him and Dar as the two guards made this team a lot different.
Swinging in the corner, Dar for three, no good. That would have been a big shot. And sometimes you can be hungry, Andrew, but you can still starve. And right now, Northern Essex starving because they can't get it going. Nice Bing. Turnaround.
Get the big man working down low. This game's going to be over real quick.
Could be a good time for Bing to take over. Jamison in the corner, being guarded by the big man out there. Big man gets back down the paint. Three-point shot by Jamison. It's good.
Ooh, easy, big
good
fella.
From the right wing, from the right side, Matthew Jamison. 53-39. Don't go away. 14-point lead. Tournament basketball. Regional tournament basketball here in Springfield. Baker, watch out. He likes to go baseline. From the elbow, Bing. No good. Over the back, number three.
There we go.
Angelo Pilato is going to be off him.
He's like already trying to give Bing a hug. Is that Hernandez? I will actually say
another,
this.
Another pass telegraph by Gomes. What's he doing? Lynch has it open. Jamison. Loses it. Hernandez bringing up the rear. No good. Tipped up by Bing. Pilato's going to come away with it. New shot clock. New 30-second shot clock.
I'm liking this Hernandez on Bing matchup. He's a lot more athletic and quicker than Moore, and he seems to be giving Bing a lot more trouble than he was getting last week.
Can frustrate the big man. Ooh, and Hernandez gets in the lane. Pass Bing. Wild shot, though. It's going to stay right here. It's going to be Northern Essex basketball.
Never hit the rim. 13 on the shot clock.
9 minutes, 20 seconds left to play. Dominic Dar kicks it way back out to Jamison. 10 on the shot clock. Swinging it in the corner. Dar loses control of it. Goes out of bounds on the maroon.
That's just frustration starting to settle in now. Now we're slowly inching. 14-point lead. Could become 16. Could become 20.
Perez up ahead to Gomes. Turns around in the lane. Jarrell Gomes time.
At 16 for the game.
Just like that, it's a 16-point lead. 16 of them by Gomes. That's the difference. And you talk about being hungry. Rob Dale Lou hasn't been, I mean, he's a little animated right now, but most of this game he's been really relaxed.
That was the most animated I've seen these guys all day. A ball on the ground, gotten by Bing, gets the timeout, and now the coach.
How about the Bayhawks, though? This is the most animated I've seen them all day.
Yeah.
I think it's sinking in that tomorrow we got Bunker Hill.
It only took them, if my math is right, 31 minutes with 9 minutes to go in the second half.
Much like we've seen last week.
If we got this animation earlier, this game could have been over a heck of a lot earlier. And then you know what that means? You can start resting players. You can start preparing even better for these Bulldogs, and you can start trying new things.
Well, the thing is, you're not going all out. They're not. They haven't showed their press. They haven't showed their pressure defense. They haven't showed any of their trapping, any of their half-court trapping or their full-court trapping. The Bayhawks have really been laid back. So, you know, like the strategy or not, I think it's all going to come to fruition tomorrow. They know that it's all about tomorrow. They can beat this team. They destroyed this team 109-75 last week and had their way with them, outscoring them, like I said before, 64-27 in the second half with that second-half explosion. They're better than this team. They know it. Northern Essex knows it. Coach Rob Dale Lou knows it. So I think that's what this is all about right now. They know that they have a huge contest tomorrow, 3 o'clock here. That's what it's going to be about. Get past this game, survive in advance. And right now they're in control. They're in control with 9 minutes left to play. So
it's all about playing smart now. Again, I'll say it like I said last week around
Essex.
This time. You got to win the head game.
Oh, nice play. Nice play by the Bayhawks. Perez underneath to a cutting Armani Baker. He's done well today for the Bayhawks.
The key for Baker is getting some,
NBA range by Jameson. He can make those, not that time. Perez, all by himself, going to bring it back out. Oh, then go back in. Dribble, somehow gets to the lane. Oh, that would have been a nice move.
You got to get the momentum for Baker. I think if you can get him going and get him excited and get him amped up, he'll be ready to play tomorrow against the bigger Bulldog team.
They're going to need him. They're going to need Jason Bing. They're going to need everybody they got. It's amazing that one more win, if they pull this out today, they can play in the big dance. Matthew Lynch with the basketball out to his brother over there, Matthew Jameson, in the corner. Brito going baseline, flies past Bing, rolls it up and in, reverse lay-in. Pretty reverse lay-in by Kevin Brito going by the big man Bing. And now going back there playing defense. I tell you, he's aggressive on both ends, that Kevin Brito. Like him a lot as a player.
Only two starters.
He knows their time is ticking.
Two starters in for the Bayhawks right now.
Gomes and Baker. Gomes directing traffic. Lynch now going after him.
Ooh. That's a foul.
That foul's going to be on Kevin Brito.
That would be Brito's third.
Got to like the effort, though, going for the basketball. Brito thought he had a shot at it, but he runs into Baker for his third foul.
I wouldn't call that running in. I'd just call it reaching around and pulling down his arm. and the Knights coach just gets a warning now.
57-41. Both teams with 5 team fouls. Ooh, Bing. Who's that foul on?
Baker. Calling for a block on Baker. That's his fourth.
Okay, so Northern Essex with the basketball. 7:38 left to play. Northern Essex, they need to show a sense of urgency. Here's Jameson driving baseline. Puts it up with his right hand on the reverse. Can't get it to go. Rebound was by Baker. Gomes being double teamed. Looks like there's going to be a foul on the play.
Who is that on? I can't tell.
Or not. Or maybe a tie-up. Maybe
no, it's a foul. It's a foul. They're going 1-1.
Okay, but the foul is on who?
Gomes.
On Gomes. When they were wrestling for the ball, okay. So fouls on Jarrell Gomes. His first foul of the day. Stepping up to the free throw line is Kevin Brito. 7 minutes and 23 seconds left. If you're Northern Essex, you gotta have a sense of urgency.
Gotta hit your free throws.
Gotta make shots. Gomes going through all of Northern Essex right now. Loses control of the basketball.
Hey, well, no, that was just a pass. Thanks.
Oh, that was just a poke. Okay.
That's a block. Can't do that. Pushing yourself into him. That's where the issue comes up. That is his sixth foul on the night, so it's going to be a long 7 minutes. Free throws from here on out.
And Josh Nelson checks in for Mr. Perez, and Steven Gonzalez will come in for Mr. Josh Banks with the blonde hair.
Fake pass.
Gonzalez trying to get it in to Ephraim. Haven't seen Ephraim in a little bit.
He was resting on the bench.
Ephraim driving the lane. Nice pass to Bing. Ephraim with a lot of good passes here today. Nice pass to Bing underneath.
That's all I wanted to see last week. That's all I wanted to see.
Penetrate the lane and dish. Let the big man get the seal and get underneath and get the basket. Driving the lane is Brito. He'll go to the line for two.
Oh, man.
He's going to get the foul.
Is third. It's okay. Brittle is 1 for 3 from the line so far. Poor free throw shooting by the Knights. They have 2 for 8.
And BCC doing a much better job than they did last week. So maybe that was a point of emphasis this week for Rob Delu.
But even then, though, like, how you can't really coach free throws. It's just you send them to the line and you keep shooting. What are you going to have them do? Shoot 100 free throws before they leave? Make 100? Old school classic.
I think this is something that you got to work on. Work ethic. Doing the same thing each and every time. Finding a rhythm. Finding something that works for you.
Free throws are muscle memory.
All concentration. Putting the pressure on. Northern Essex. Nelson loves to go behind the back for no reason. Dominic Dar got the numbers. Jamison on the left side. Puts it up with the left hand and in. On the pass by Dar.
Again,
14-point lead.
There was no need for Nelson to go behind his back there. He had a wide open lane with a left-hand dribble, and he's strong with his left.
Not for sure. Bayhawks got to be careful with the basketball. Northern Essex is coming with their defense.
Triple team in the corner.
Triple team
and Nelson gets out of it.
Coach Rob Delu, I think that's a good timeout there. It's a 14-point lead. 6 minutes left to play. If you're the Northern Essex, you get a couple steals. We know that they got three-point shooters. All of a sudden, if Dar starts getting hot, Jamison, Matthew Lynch, if these guys start getting hot from the outside, next thing you know, you're cutting that lead to under 10. If they can get the lead to under 10,
it's a game.
If they can get it to under 10 with about 4 minutes to play, it's a game.
Now, do you think that's actually going to happen?
It could, because sometimes the Bayhawks, they can get a little lackadaisical.
I look at this lineup that's about to come out right now. There's no way.
No, they shouldn't.
They just threw out the starters, except
for Gonzalez and Bing.
Are they leaving Bing on? It looks like Cotton's trying to get in. Somebody is trying to get in this game.
He's trying to. Looks like he's cleaning the floor, though, so I don't
All
think
right,
he's coming
so
in.
So he's not in.
Cotton playing the janitor role right now.
He was ready to go in.
Of course he's ready to go in. Jarrell Gomes looking inbound for the Bayhawks. We got a little wet spot on the floor here.
Everybody putting in a lending hand.
Good to see. Teamwork. Teamwork makes the dream work.
But I'm also going to blame the Bayhawks for this. They need to have better water drinking to not spill on the court next time, during the next timeout.
How did a water spill get out there?
Well, because at the timeout, they have one guy run over to the water bottle, pick up a bunch of cups of water, and bring it over. Now you might have to limit the number of water cups you bring over in a trip, but you cannot have any spillage on the court. That is just very dangerous.
That's for sure. Someone could break their neck. 59-45.
10 on the shot clock.
Trip to tomorrow's final on the line. Nelson.
Travel.
Going to be a travel. Going to be a travel call. See, turnovers. Turnovers are key.
Nelson, just stop. You're not going to win that one. He blew the whistle. It was traveling. You should have passed it or just shot it.
I want to see the Bayhawks. I want the ball in Ephraim's hands. He seems to be their best passer.
That is the fourth foul charged to Gonzalez.
And see, the Bayhawks find themselves in a very dangerous position. They are, I mean, they have nine team fouls. I know Northern Essex has not made their free throws, hasn't done a good job of making their free throws.
But now they're starting to do it.
Yeah. So just like that, a 13-point lead with 5:55 left. You turn the ball over a couple times. You can't afford to foul. Everything is going to be two shots after the next foul.
It's only a 12-point lead.
12-point lead. And they're bringing the pressure. Let's see how the Bayhawks handle the pressure. Nelson. And they swarm at you, too. They do a good job of switching defenders. Ooh, in the lane. Efren with a nice pass to Gonzalez. Oh, what a block by Brito.
Brito said go home.
Ephraim does a great job of penetrating the lane and finding guys on the inside. Does a great job of that. He's done a great job of doing that today. That's why I said I want to see him with the basketball. Here's Ephraim being guarded by the gritty Brito. Back up to Nelson.
Nelson's not going
to
shoot.
Driving to his right. Puts it up. Lays it in. That's a big shot by Nelson. Nelson driving to his right with the floater in the lane. It's good.
If I'm guarding Nelson, every time he gets the ball out in the corner, I'm not even going.
Oh, that's a
to
bad
fall
pass.
For that head
bad
fake.
Pass by Lynch. Ephraim kind of walking it up court and lays it in easily with the ease. And just like that, it's back out to 16. What a turn of events.
Keep that foot
Brito
on the gas
kicks pedal. It back out to Jamison. Jamison for three. Good. Big three by Jamison.
Keeps this
game
close.
It's a 13-point lead. Five minutes to play.
Keeps this game close. That is not what you want to see. That is 10 points for Jamison this half.
And Gonzalez throws that one to the official scorer over there.
Now
the DJ.
The
DJ. Sorry.
I think he wanted a request. Basketball by Lil Bow Wow. I think that was the hint.
No, what was that song? Remember, I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was like ski low.
I
wish
know.
I was a baller.
I have no clue.
Maybe I'm not doing it justice. Lynch back up to Brito. Brito driving against the big man. Bing. Bing doing a good job using his body. And that's going to stay right here. It's going to be off from Ronnie Baker.
He's getting pushed down, ref. What do you expect him to do?
4 minutes and 40 seconds to play. Again, 13-point lead. Bayhawks have controlled this one for most of the evening, but being killed. Oh, Ephraim. Good job by Ephraim.
Give it a
gonna
go.
Take
it
all the way. You're going to get fouled.
1-1 for Ephraim.
Both teams are in the bonus now.
1-1 for Ephraim.
We'll see if Ephraim can continue to have a decent afternoon shooting from the free throw line.
Hey.
Bounces that one up the front rim and it drops in.
Get that shooter's touch.
Jarrell Gomes, number one. Number 14, Armani Baker. Number 13, Jeremiah Ephraim at the line. Number four, Josh Nelson. And number 30, Jason Bing, the center, in for the Bayhawks. Lynch back out. Jamison with that NBA range. Three is good. Matthew Jamison for three.
He's having himself a night.
Large and in charge. Nelson driving the lane. Scoops it up off the glass.
Why?
Rolls out.
Why
rebounded by Brito. Brito loses control of it. Now loses it out of bounds.
No.
And it's going to stay here.
Sir, we have video proof that went off his knee.
I don't think there's an instant replay here in the NJCAA.
I just want him to know he's going to go home tonight, watch this rebroadcast, and see it went right off his knee.
Oh, God, you're worse than Tommy. Tommy Heinsohn. Dominic Dar back out to Brito. Bayhawks staying in that little laissez-faire zone. Oh, turnover by the Northern Essex, bringing it up court. Ooh, nice scoop up and under.
No.
Oh, why did he do that?
Baker.
Armani Baker. That ball looked like it was going to drop
it
in anyway.
Gonna drop.
That was going to drop in. That was going to be an N1. And Jeremiah Ephraim will step up to the line for two, but he should be going to the line for an N1. He should be going to the line to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. And now
that hurts. That's okay. So now he would have had two. So that would have gone, that's already a minus one. You guys got to use your, this is only a 12-point lead.
And Armani Baker taken out of the game by Coach Rob Delu. Coach Rob Delu didn't like that, sending a message to Armani Baker. Leave that one alone. 66-53. A shame because Baker's had a good game. But, you know, people make mistakes. Can't blame him for being overly aggressive. Jamison feeling it for three. No good this time. That would have been huge.
2-on-1 break.
The other end. Perez loses the ball out of bounds.
What the heck is going
Perez
on?
Perez had Banks. He had numbers. He had a chance to dish it off to Banks. He kept it too long. Loses it out of bounds.
Coach Rob's facial expression on that. Hands in the face. Gives the nice long drag because I don't know what's going on right now. You have a 12-point lead, 13-point lead.
Oh, nice backdoor cut. Jamison going to the, going up. Not sure where he was trying to put it up. Perez up to Banks. Going for the lay-in. And he'll lay it in.
That's Banks' first points of the night.
Banks' first points off the bench, 68-53. Brittle down low, puts it up. And tipped in by...
You say tipped, I say punched.
Punched in by Angelo Pilato. Oh, up to Bing, gonna lay it up and in. And Bing...
Let's just stop playing defense now. Score.
Yeah. That's what it looks like. It looks like both teams have stopped playing defense now. Dominic Dar swings it. Here's a three. Pilato, no good.
Gomes
comes up with it.
Smart move, Gomes. Slow it down. No need to push it anymore.
That's what they need to do. Gomes should be backing in Dar here. Got to give it to him. Dar is quick as heck. Ooh, getting into the lane. Finding a way. Forces it up and in. Doesn't get the foul call
Gomes,
he wants, and he's not going to get it.
That's one thing that infuriates me. If you don't get the foul call, just get right back up. You're going to hold your team because you have
JHB for three, no good. Rebounded by Bing.
You left him open with a wide open three because you were sitting down getting the call. You got to stop that out. Just let the call go. Get up and do your thing.
And especially when you're up 17 here, Ephraim had a chance to pull it from the short little 12-foot jumper. No good. Rebounded by Bing. And Bing quietly has had himself a pretty good second half here.
Ten points for Bing. Drops it like it's hot.
Most of them coming here in the second half. He's had an impact.
No, he's had 12 on the night. 10 this half.
Oh, 10 in this half. Very good. Dar for three. Haven't seen too much of that. Rebounded by Banks. Dominic Dar having an off afternoon. I think his lack of production has really put Northern Essex, the Knights, in the ringer.
90 seconds left.
Ooh, inside to Bing. Bing dominating
and
now.
One.
I told you, they should have got this guy involved earlier in the game. He'd have about 30 points right now.
I
said that. Goodness gracious.
Big man down low. They don't have an answer.
Well, he towers over everybody. I mean, he's more athletic than Felix Moore, who's the only guy that can match up physically, I think, with him. But Felix Moore, not the physical specimen that can match up with the likes of Bing. And then everyone else, he just towers over. He just towers over them. He's a presence inside. Can't complete the three-point play. But a good, pretty good evening here for Jason Bing.
Is this the first time Desire's checking in tonight? Oh, we got a foul. That's a bad foul. You don't need to take that.
No, Kevin Desire made a cameo in the first half. Along with Jason Bing. That's why I was saying earlier, we haven't seen too much of these bigger guys for the Bayhawks, but Jason Bing has been a catalyst here in the second half.
Looks like we're getting the MC. I can't even remember the letters from last week.
The NECC.
That's it.
Champion, the state champion, Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs. Looking forward to that matchup tomorrow. We have 1 minute left, 1 minute and 9 seconds left, but this game is academic, 76-56, the Bayhawks lead. Very much in control of this one. Obviously, it's a 20-point lead for them. Still under their season average of nearly 85, 86 points a game that they've been averaging throughout the year, but...
It's the second.
Looking very much forward to tomorrow's championship game here in Springfield. Going to be spending the night here in the good old... City of Springfield going to be staying here.
Who's that foul on? Number 11, Lynch, his fourth.
So, again, we have the number one and number two seeds matched up again in the championship game. And this is going to be huge. The rematch. This is what they wanted. You know this is what they wanted. They know it's all on the line tomorrow. This is bigger stakes. You lost last week. That was the battle. This is the war.
Hits them both.
Both free throws made by Perez. Lynch driving all the way to the lane. Like I said, I don't know.
With the foul somewhere. Didn't see it.
Like I said, I don't know how Matthew Lynch.
No, they're going to call that on.
I don't know how Matthew Lynch Stopka. Slides by defenders.
Stopka got the foul.
Oh, Stopka.
Did you even know he was in?
Didn't even know he was in. I'd like to see him get on the board. When he scores, the crowd, the Bayhawks bench goes crazy.
I'll go crazy.
And the BCC fans go crazy when Ryan Stopka gets in the game and can get on the scoreboard.
Who do we have to talk to get this game tomorrow moved to Bishop Conley for us?
Hey, you can always get that hotel room. See you at the hotel. It's Steven Gonzalez. Try to flip it up to Desire. Way over his head.
Stop. Stop doing that shenanigans.
Trying to showboat.
Right now.
Steven Gonzalez, number five. No. Sophomore. Shaysby for three. Gets it to go. Pretty shot by Shaysby, dropping it in for three. Little bit too late, though, for Northern Essex as they come up with a triple team on Perez.
Perez
scoots by. Try to get to Stopka.
Nice bounce pass.
Miguel Tejada also in. Number 11 for the Bayhawks with Perez. 25 in the game clock. Stopka for three.
Splash.
Oh,
nice
no
pass.
Good. Rebounded by Gonzalez. Going to get it back up to Stopka.
He's going to shoot it.
Stopka.
It's going to go in, though.
Oh, no good. The shot clock winds down.
I'm trying to yell at him to shoot it.
You know what? I always feel bad for a guy like that that gets in for the last 30 seconds or so, and then the team is trying to get him that shot. I just feel bad for the guy.
Oh, no. Nah. He's going.
Felix
Big Moore, man for three.
Felix Moore in the corner for three.
That should be the game.
Shot clock, I mean the clock winding down. 2 seconds, 1 second, that's it. Your Bristol Community College Bayhawks will be advancing to play in a rematch of last week's NECCAC final where the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs won last week and won the state championship. It's going to be a rematch between the Bayhawks and the Bulldogs tomorrow at 3 o'clock. The winner gets to advance to New York. The final here, 78-62. The Bayhawks are a winner. Advance into tomorrow's Region 21 regional tournament final. Like I said, a trip to New York to the Nationals is on the line.
I can't even make this up. Both of those halves were identical for scoring because 78 divided by 2, 39.
Yep.
62 divided by 2, 31. That was the score at the end of the first half. It was just two evenly played halves, plain and simple.
And the Bayhawks just showed that they're the better team.
No, they are the far better team. And
they definitely
no
showed. They definitely showed that they're the better team today. They weren't putting the foot on the throat. They didn't really have to. They didn't put the gas pedal all the way down. They didn't have to. I thought they were playing three-quarter speed the whole game, and they still come out with a 16-point victory, 78-62, pretty convincing fashion. They're just a better team. They won last week by 35. They win this game by 16. So a final between the Bulldogs and the Bayhawks, pretty inevitable. So 78-62. David Cardoza and Mr. Andrew Augustus. Get that. That's Mr. Double A. Get that straight. So we're going to take a break here. We're going to come back with the post game. Well, a little bit of post game action. All right. Welcome back, everybody, to Springfield Technical Community College here in Springfield, Massachusetts, home of the Basketball Hall of Fame. We just seen the Bristol Community College Bayhawks take care of Northern Essex. Northern Essex Community College 78-62. That is the final score. And Andrew, I mean, Bayhawks not playing their best basketball today, like I said, survive in advance. But really, I mean, we're obviously the more talented team, more athletic team. And tomorrow we have a rematch. The Bulldogs, the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs, the state champions, the MCCAC champions, who beat the Bayhawks last week in Boston in that final in heartbreaking fashion. The Bayhawks kind of lost control of that game in the last few minutes of that game. What do the Bayhawks need to do differently?
They need to be hungry. Even last week, I didn't see the hunger. And today, only for like maybe two or three different occasions, I actually saw them hungry, ready to fight. Yes, you guys won. Yeah, you're getting a rematch. Remember what happened last week. This team out-physicaled you. They got in your heads. You were undisciplined. The only way the Bayhawks stand a chance winning tomorrow is if they can stay out of foul trouble. You need Bing. You need Desire. You need your big men to not foul out. They had four foul outs last week. That is unacceptable if they want to be a championship team.
And it seemed like last week the Bulldogs, they just wanted it more. It seemed like they just wanted it more down the stretch. They kind of willed their way to that victory. And talk about the big guys of the Bulldogs. They got a few big guys on that team that are very lengthy, very athletic. I mean, we've seen the one player for the Bulldogs.
David Stewart. That's who you want to look out for. The big man down low, going off. Loves going to the line. Loves getting in your head. Now, if there were some calls last week that could have gone either way. So it's going to be interesting to see having a neutral court, neutral officials on this area take place and how the game is called, because no matter who the officials are, it's always going to have an impact on the game if they call a tight or a loose game. If it's a tight game and it's tight both ways, who knows what's going to happen. If it's a looser game, I think it's going to play off to the Bayhawks' advantage. Now, last week they tried to get in down low. They realized they couldn't. Let's see if they learn their lesson, if they're going to keep it on the perimeter and try to hit some more jumpers, because if they can start hitting their jumpers, they should win that game.
And Elijah Rogers, we've seen the impact that he had on the team. He went out last week with an injury. It looked like it was pretty grim after that, but when he came back in, the floor general really took over the game. He really controls that offense. He really is the captain of that ship. He's the one that keeps that ship afloat.
Yeah, I'm definitely happy to see that they came out and were able to get the win today to kind of rebound from that loss. But now you're on that mindset is we need to beat this team that ended our streak. We've done it before on their court. Let's do it on a neutral floor.
It's going to be a lot different game on a neutral court. This is where you want them. With the regional championship on the line last week, you know, Bulldogs had it on their court last time. It was a very tightly contested game, too, as we've seen Stewart go to the line for, what, over 20 free throws?
Oh, that was
a huge difference.
I started losing count. But that's going to be an interesting thing. We can talk more about that tomorrow. But just to kind of wrap things up here today, coming into this, I knew the Bayhawks should have won and should have won big. And the victory today could have been bigger, could have been better, but it's still a win. Like you said, survive in advance. We're advancing to tomorrow.
All you got to do is win tomorrow. That's it. You win tomorrow. They're going to New York. We're going to New York. So it's a big game. It's going to be we're looking forward to it tomorrow. So tomorrow at 3 p.m., join us on frmedia.org. We'll be live streaming that game right here from Springfield Technical Community College. The Bayhawks winners today in the regional tournament semifinal game against Northern Essex, 78-62 for David Cardoza and Mr. AA Andrew Augusta.
Got to give big props to Steve Rice,
and
too.
Big props
great
to Steve Rice
behind
with
it.
All the guy that makes all the big bucks.
He makes the magic happen.
He makes it all happen. He makes the magic happen. So kudos to Mr. Steve Rice for setting us up for success here from Springfield Technical Community College. So tomorrow, championship's at stake. Championship is at stake. 3 p.m. tomorrow right here from Springfield Technical Community College. David Cardoza, Andrew Augusta, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball. Bayhawks are a winner. They'll be playing for the title tomorrow for Region 21.